la película premiada en la categoría de Mejor Película Animada en la 80ª edición del Oscar fue Ratatouille.
Gracias por seguir aquí en Hollywood Café. Ahora vamos a conversar con uno de los productores de Brasil más reconocidos del mundo y que presentará en la edición 2008 del Beverly Hills Film Festival su más reciente película titulada Bad Guys. Federico, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, Carol. Oh.
Thank you for being here. I forgot. We're speaking in English now. I like it better. Federico, tell us a little bit about how you got involved in the movie business, especially coming from Brazil.
It was always a dream of mine to produce motion pictures. As a little kid, I used to watch films and wonder how, you know, how the whole thing took place. And when I turned 15, I started, you know, putting my game plan together. And when I was 18, I came to America.
You gotta have a game plan to get in this business, right?
That's right.
Yeah.
And then at 18, I immigrated. Mm-hmm. I went to school, I studied, got my degree, and
you gotta go to school, everybody.
Yes, school helps a lot.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about this script. How did this come about for you? Why were you interested in making this film, Bad Guys?
When I was going to school, I met the writer of this script, Tim Cockshell, an American film writer, very talented. Mm-hmm. And the script stayed in my mind. And the time went by, and you know, 10 years later, I called him saying—
10 years later?
Yes. Asking if he still had this script available. He did. And
what stuck in your mind about it? What is it about the story that you wanted to tell?
The dynamic of four people, because I think the bad guys is a thing that happens a lot in life where you're so close of achieving what you want, yet you sabotage by making assumptions.
Right. And so you gave him a call, you make this film, and you were saying, Is it all in English? Because we were having this whole discussion about English and Spanish.
Yeah. Actually, what I did with this film is, as a Latino filmmaker, my goal is to help Latinos to find a place in Hollywood. But what I want to do in a different way. My approach is I want to do films in English, but give the lead roles to Latino. I think Latinos are the most powerful race, coming up race in the world right now.
I think so too. We have Javier Bardem.
Absolutely.
Took one home for us last night. What did you think about the Oscars?
I agreed with a lot of the results. I think it was good. It's a beautiful party, you know, and then how it celebrates the industry.
Yeah.
And everybody that makes dreams come true, you know.
And how about as a producer, which film was your favorite this past year?
I liked There Will Be Blood. I thought there was some very—
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yeah, unbelievable performance, absolutely.
Did you like the Coen Brothers? Did you like No Country for Old Men?
I liked it, but I liked that There Will Be Blood a little bit better.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And tell me a little bit about how you got involved with the Beverly Hills Film Festival. How do you get in? How do you break into something like that?
I actually submit the film and you know, they go through their analysis. I don't know how the process works internally. I love the Beverly Hills Film Festival. In my opinion, it's one of the best ones in the world. You know,
why is that? Will you explain to us?
I think they are not commercial. They're not ran by the major corporations or studios. Mm-hmm. And you know, I think they give filmmakers a fair chance. And never mind the fact that it's in the most prestigious city in the world, Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
The people who run the show are very talented, and you know, I had the chance to go to two editions of the festival, and I was, for me, it's a dream come true to be able to have a film there now.
It is incredible. And how is it working with Kate Del Castillo? You know, how was it working with her?
Kate,
we got a lot of her fans here.
Yeah, Kate is a very talented actress.
Yeah,
she very professional. Mm-hmm. She came earlier, left afterwards, she did her own stunts. She knew her lines, even though English is not her first language, she does speak it very well.
Yeah.
But
I feel like we as Latinos like appreciate it. I think we work that much harder. I mean, you kind of appreciate the job, you know? It's so hard to break in. It's so hard to get those big, you know, those big spots.
Absolutely.
Those lead roles.
Yeah. She was superb. It was such a joy every moment. Not one complaining, you know, independent filmmaking, there are many obstacles. And you always try to make things happen, you know,
yeah,
on a tight budget. But she always had good spirits. She was the true lead,
yeah,
of the movie, and not only in the as a character, but with her attitude.
And tell us a little bit of what's coming up next for you.
Well, coming next to me, I have Macumba, which we're shooting, still shooting in Louisiana, and I think that's the next
project. That's a big
thing. That's the next one.
Well, we hope you're going to come back and talk to us about Mukumba.
I hope so, Carolina.
Thank you so much for talking to us. We really appreciate it. Y suerte, which is good luck at the film festival. We'll be looking out for you for sure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bueno, gracias por sus palabras. ¿Y qué le parece si ahora le damos una probadita a la gente de su obra? Veamos.
Ashley works his magic in our lab, and we all get rich selling the hottest new designer drugs in ecstasy.
What's my name?
Intense. We just killed a big black Jeff. You know what that means? It means we're dead.
What makes you think I won't just walk away from this?
At least let me kill him.
Oh man, not dead. I hate dead.
Let's do that right here.
If I wanted to kill you, you'd all be dead already.
True story, but it'll make a great movie. Trying to get my cheese. Why y'all hate on me? Why I gotta be the bad guy?